let us ask our lady to give us her heart, so beautiful, so pure, so immaculate, her heart so full of love and humility, that we may be able to receive Jesus, the bread of life, love him as she loved him, and serve him in the distressing disguise of the poorest of the poor. Let us thank God for his great love in creating us all for greater things, to love and to be loved. The aim of our congregation is to satiate the thirst of Jesus on the cross for love for souls by working at the salvation and sanctification of the poorest of the poor. That's why we have all these homes for sick and dying, for people, the unborn and the unloved, all over the world. At present we are in 126 countries and have 556 tabernacles, but Jesus and Mary are loved and served by the sisters to spread his love and compassion everywhere. Pray for us that we may continue this beautiful work with love and humility. God has blessed us with very beautiful vocations, and we have just lately here had in Washington and in New York, we have the sisters who met. One group took final vows and one group took first vows. So I thank the families who have been generous in giving their daughters to become the spouses of Jesus crucified. Pray for us that we may continue this beautiful work of love throughout the world. People are very, very helpful and anxious to share the joy of loving with us. We have, in a very special way, we have also leprosy. We have rehabilitation centers for leprosy patients, and they have something very beautiful that is new life, new joy, and they are working, and as you see, the lepers make that, and I pay them full money, and they have their own family life, and their children are growing and going to school. And we are now also working with AIDS patients all over the place. Here in the United States, we have a number of houses, but in other countries also. So pray for us that we may continue this beautiful gift of God with great love. We also are fighting abortion, the greatest evil of today. And if mother kills, murders her own child, this has been created for greater things, the child of God, to love and to be loved. Thousands and millions of children are being killed by their own mother, the child that has been created to love and to be loved for greater things. We have been able to give in adoption over 3,500 children already, and they have been such a beautiful gift of God to their families who could not have naturally a child of their own. And this is a really wonderful love gift to those families. It has brought so much love and peace. And I'm hoping on the 19th of this month, we are going to open a house for adopting children in Washington. So please pray that we do this beautiful work with full love and share that joy with families that cannot have a child, but I'll be able to give them the joy of a family life. The sisters, as you know, we are all over the place, all over the world, and one of the things that today we have been able to save thousands of children and help many, many families to pray together and to love, because family that prays together stays together. And if they stay together, they will love each other as God loves each one of them. This has been a wonderful gift of God. And lately, I have started a new work. I have taken non-guilty, non-criminals from the jail. 35 young girls who were brought for prostitution, and then when they were put in that life, they all ran away. And God knows how the people told the police called them, put them in jail. And then any old crippled, old women that were left in the street, they also were taken to jail. And I offered to take, one day the chief minister told me, "Mother, they are all innocent girls, please do something." So I took them all from jail, and I brought them, and also the mental ones came to me, "Do something for us also." So I took them also. See, something, such a beautiful gift of God for our Hindu families have been touched so much by this, and non-stop they come and help me to help these people that have been suffering so much in this, being kept in jail without any fault or guilt of theirs. So this has been something, I was so happy to be able to this bring Jesus right in the jail and help these people to come out and live a normal life. And that starts the life of the Hindu family so much that non-stop they come and help me. And now the government also has passed the rule that non-guilty, non-criminals should not be kept in jail. They are non-guilty people, so we must help Mother Teresa to take care of them all, since she is ready to love them. This is something so beautiful to see the joy of loving, and it has spread this love everywhere. Men, women, children are coming close and coming helping. A big group of young men got together and they have made a society called Hope. And the aim of the society to help hopeless people. So they had a big meeting and they said, "Who is the most hopeless person just now?" "Mother Teresa." And so they put all their sacrifice money together and they went and they bought blankets and clothes and all kinds of things for the jail people. It was such a touching, beautiful thought and sharing the love with our poor people, with the jail people, with so much tenderness and kindness. This is the way I see that Jesus is doing some really wonderful things through this sick and the dying, the crippled, the maimed, the lepers, the unwanted and unkempt. So he pray for us that we may continue this beautiful gift of God with great love. And this spot is the great strength and joy and love that fills our hearts is Jesus in the Blessed Sacrament. We have Holy Mass and Holy Communion every morning, but every day we have one full hour of adoration. And this has been, I think, the greatest gift of God to our congregation, to have the daily adoration. So we have the poor, and we have Jesus in the Blessed Sacrament the whole time. Because Jesus said very clearly, "Whatever you do to the least, you did it to me." When we are 24 hours with them, the dying, the crippled, the mental, the lepers, the unwanted, there's all kinds of things. And so you pray for us that we don't spoil this beautiful work and that we grow in holiness through being in touch the whole time with Jesus in the poor and Jesus in the Blessed Sacrament. We have now in our congregation active and contemplative sisters, active and contemplative brothers. We have fathers, we have lay missionaries of charity, husband and wife, and then we have co-workers. And in the co-workers groups, and all kinds of people can join in serving the poor together with us. Pray for us that we may continue God's work. And you will be very glad to know that lately I have opened 2 houses in Vietnam. It is still very, very common, it's very strong. But the miracle of God that I was asked by the government to come and open their house. And on arriving, the bishop had prepared 20 beautiful vocations. I hope the bishop will prepare, give me some more vocations also. I have never seen prayer and real fervent prayer and as I saw in Vietnam. After these years, and still now, very strong communism is there. But morning and evening, Holy Mass, and both times, two priests giving Holy Communion. And then there in the house, they have a very big frame of teacher with all the martyrs that have died for the faith. And night and day, life is burning. So let us thank God that our sisters have gone out there now to give that tender love and care to the poor and those beautiful vocations that they may be able to soon to be able to join the novitiate. And Bishop himself has been training them. So I think it will be a wonderful thing that they have been so beautifully prepared. The people are very, very, very fervent in their prayer. So I hope that with God's blessing, more openness will come. And we have been able also, when in Russia, they had that terrible earthquake, I offered the sisters to Mr. Gorbachev. And he immediately accepted the sisters. And I took the sisters to open the house in Moscow. And to our great joy, and I told Our Lady, and praying to her, Mother Mary, I will give you the 15 mysteries of the Rosary if you help me to bring Jesus fully in Russia. And miracle has happened. I have opened 15 houses in Russia. So. Already we have started getting some wonderful vocations. As you know, for 70 years the whole church has been closed there, but now everything is beautifully open and beautiful vocations are coming and to share, to give their life to Jesus. We need lots of prayer that we don't spoil God's work, that it remains His. And many, what has been the most beautiful part, that many people have a beautiful opportunity to serve God in the poor. So more and more people are making many sacrifices to come and help the sisters and the brothers that are working with the poorest of the poor. So pray for us that we may continue God's work with great love. We have now 6 novitiates and they are full. We have a novitiate in Calcutta, in Rome, in Poland, in San Francisco, in Nairobi and in Philippines. And everywhere is a beautiful vocation, many. So let us thank God for His great love in using small things to do such beautiful, great thing, and to bring so many souls to Jesus. And it's unbelievable that those more than 50,000 have died in our home for their dying in Calcutta. And not one has died without the ticket for St. Peter. We call baptism ticket for St. Peter. When I began the work, I went in my dream to heaven. And St. Peter said, God, go back. There are no slums in heaven. And I got so angry with him. I said, I will fill heaven with slum people. And already 50,000 have gone. So he must be surprised. What is Mother Teresa doing, sending so many up there? So pray for us. That never miss a chance of helping a soul to go home to God. And my gratitude is that to pray for that we may be able to help as many poor people as possible. And you will be also very happy to know that with Father Forrest, we have together started in adopting the priests. All the nuns of the world have offered to pray for one priest. So when we went to Holy Father for his blessing, Holy Father said, Mother Teresa, make sure somebody adopts me because I'm also a priest. So one of our sisters adopted him. And up to now, we have adopted 43,600 priests from all over the world by all the nuns. So pray for us that we don't spoil God's work, that it remains His for the glory of God and the good of people. God bless you.